deliberation from our other panelists. Now I introduce Mr. V. Krishna Murthy. Of course, as Mr. Pradeep said, he does not need an introduction, but it's my duty to. He's a chartered accountant and company secretary, a unique combination for professional angle. And he's a managing director of Four P International, which he started some time back, and he's managing a different capacity for last over 15 years. And his main product is black mud pay, which he's for last two decades he has been milling and trading. They got a good name for the quality, and they command good reputation and goodwill in the market. He has served as the secretary of Tamil Nadu Pulses Import Association also, and he has represented the industry with Chennai Customs, Port, and other authority. Whenever there is some issues or some problems, he really takes this on to those agencies. And he is now popular in the various print and electronic media of late to share his views on black mud pay after his last debate or discussion organized by IPGA, which was quite interesting, and we all watched with great interest. So, and he's a speaker, of course, on IPGA conclave. He's a good friend of mine, and I would call upon Mr. Murthy to share about it. He's on especially on Urad, which is certainly a very interesting product. Thank you, Mr. Murthy, please.
Thank you, Mr. Bangad. Such a nice introduction about me. I will take about 6 to 7 minutes, and I will speak in such a way that even a layman can understand about Urad. So give me this seven minutes time so that I will just give a bird's eye view of what is happening around about Urad. Sure. Now, and I also speak in such a way that even layman can understand.
Please.
Hello, distinguished panelists, distinguished guests and friends and colleagues from industry. A very good afternoon to all of you. At the outset, I profusely thank IPGA for this opportunity. It's my privilege to be a panelist in this August discussion on Thor, Urad and Moong. I'm advised to give my perspective on India Urad production, price and trade volumes and expectations for the forthcoming year. Let me make a small introduction about this particular pulse Urad. It's popularly known as black gram, and in international trade parlance, it is known as black mud pay. Its botanical name is Vigna Moongo. This is a very popular pulse mainly in South India and chiefly used for breakfast snacks like idli, vada, dosa, etc. that everybody knows. It's very popular not only now in South India, it's also very popular now across the world, I would say, not only India, but also the world. For example, when I went to Israel about 2 years back as a delegate of South India Chamber of Commerce and Industry, I had the opportunity to eat one snack called falafel. And falafel, an ingredient of falafel is urad dal. I was very surprised to see this. And well, if you go to USA and all that, there are so many lakhs of Indians, they all use urad dal in their breakfast snacks. Black gram is very nutritious and is very good for health. It has roughly 28% protein content on its dry weight basis and supplies dietary fiber, vitamin D complex, iron, copper, calcium, magnesium, zinc, phosphorus, and it's also very good for healthy skin and hair. Black gram is grown mainly as rabi and kharif crop. Out of production in the country, nearly 25% of production comes from rabi and 75% comes from kharif. So now the kharif is already over, now we are into rabi production now. This is mainly grown only in two countries, India and Myanmar. I have not come across any third country which has been growing urad, although Thailand used to grow, but somehow Thailand crop is not very successful and then buyers don't want to buy Thailand. I now understand that Brazil is trying out production of black gram also, but it is very in a very nascent stage. So I would say that India is mainly, urad is mainly grown only in India and Myanmar. See, urad has a very peculiar characteristic, which other pulses don't have. For example, it has no substitute. For example, you take the case of Thor, it has alternatives like lentils, peas, etc. If Thor production is low and insufficient to meet domestic demand, consumers can shift to other pulses like lentils or peas, which have similar taste and protein content. Whereas if availability of urad is scarce, consumers have no choice but to buy this product or else they have to forego its consumption. India has been meeting its domestic needs by steadily improving domestic crop size while importing only the shortfall from Myanmar. India's dependence on Myanmar has, in the recent years, been steadily declining, mainly for the reason that the domestic crop size has been steadily going up because of huge demand for domestic urad vis-a-vis the imported urad. For example, 2010-11, India produced 1.7 million tons of urad. In a span of 8 years, it went up to 3 million tons in the year 2018-19. This is as per the data available from Ministry of Agriculture. So as a result, during the last 3 years, policy decisions have been taken to curtail imports by eliminating imports of urad from OGL and by introducing a quota system by the government of India, because there was no need for an unlimited supply from Myanmar. Also, farmers are constantly encouraged to shift from other crops to pulses like urad, as they find this crop to be very remunerative, especially because it is very good for preservation of soil, as well as the minimum price support being given by the government of India has been steadily and consistently going up. Like, for example, a decade ago, 10 years back, the MSP was 2,900 rupees. Now, in the year 2020, it is 6,000 rupees per quintal. So it is obviously a very good, I would say, incentive to the farmer to produce more of urad. I now come to production figures. I take the year as October 2020 to September 2021. See, there are two main cropping seasons, as I said, as Kharif and Rabi. Kharif is already over, but I just briefly explain what happened in Kharif. 2020 Kharif was sown in nearly 38 lakh hectares. And as you all know, Madhya Pradesh in the recent years has emerged to be the highest growing state, with sowing of more than 40% of the total Kharif urad crop. Next is followed closely by Uttar Pradesh with 18%, Maharashtra and Rajasthan with 10% each, Gujarat and Karnataka with 3% each, and few other states contributing very insignificant numbers. Kharif started off very well with the good rains in June, but rains fell short in July. August literally dumped huge rains in almost all urad growing states like Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, Gujarat, Karnataka, etc. Such heavy rains and huge rains were not seen in India in the last 44 years. Normally, such heavy sowing at 38 lakh hectares should ideally give an yield of approximately 29 lakh tons or 2.9 million tons. But I suspect because of this untimely huge and torrential rains, actual production was not more than 11 lakh tons, which is a huge short supply. However, the government of India thinks that the crop size of urad kharif at 21.5 lakh tons as per their first advance estimate. My idea is, as I said before, the crop size during the crop kharif was not more than 11 lakh tons. I guess my estimate turned out to be close to true, because otherwise I give a simple reason. We have not even finished 5 months after the kharif is harvested. Now we are only into February beginning. Already North Indian millers are coming into South India to buy urad. Why do they come to South India to buy urad when they have such a huge crop of 21 lakh tons as suggested by the government of India? I don't think that advance estimate is closer to the reality. I guess, but let me tell you firstly that all my figures are given based out of my own personal experience and my own personal estimate. So please don't think, this is something very scientifically done or very mathematically done. I have my own way of doing small calculations. Therefore, based on that, I'm telling the figures. So members or spectators or, people who are listening to me, they may agree or they may not agree. This is a disclaimer. So looking at the demand from North India, from South India, I presume that the kharif crop was not more than 11 lakh tons. Now I come to Rabi season. So Rabi season so far, as on 29th January, that's about 10 days back, the sowing was at around 8 lakh 10 lakh hectares vis-a-vis 50,000 hectares last year. This Rabi crop comes mainly from southern states like Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, and Telangana. Tamil Nadu and a part of Andhra Pradesh recently in the month of November experienced huge rains, which had adversely affected the standing crop of urad, especially in Tamil Nadu. Ideally, this Rabi sowing of around 8.10 lakh tons should yield about 7 lakh tons of, ideally this sowing of 8.1 lakh hectares should ideally yield around 7 lakh tons of urad. But taking into consideration the crop which is to be harvested post mid-March 2021, the crop size already harvested should have yielded at least 3.5 lakh tons. But I guess this much crop doesn't look like to have been harvested because prices continue to remain firm. My guess is total Rabi crop size won't cross more than 6.5 lakh tons. India is almost finishing its import quota issued by the government of India of about 150,000 tons. It's going to finish imports on or before the stipulated date of 31st March 2021. I hope Myanmar political situation won't create any hurdles. I guess now I come to consumption. Consumption of urad in India, in my guesstimate, is approximately 21 to 22 lakh tons in the year 2020-21. Although I normally maintain 22 to 24 lakh tons of urad consumption every year, but I have reduced it by about 2 lakh tons because of the impact of COVID in the year 2020 and some other reasons. Considering the availability and consumption figures, I guess we are heading towards a stock situation where production, imports, and consumption are likely to match with each other. I also expect there might be a need to issue fresh permits faster so that imports continue to happen after 31st March 2021. As regards the forthcoming year, which IPGA requested me to give a view about, forthcoming year means 2021 October to 2022 October. If the rainfall is normal and if the rainfall is not abnormal, we could see huge urad production, which could run into easily 3 million tons and which could result in considerable price drop. I'm talking about 2021-22, please don't confuse. We are now in 2020-21. I'm estimating 2021-22 to be a plenty of urad year provided rainfall is not abnormal. And why I am saying the crop would be so high at 3 million tons in the next 2021-22 is because urad prices have been very remunerative to the farmers, domestic farmers. And I'm very sure they are enthused to grow more and more, resulting in what I just said, huge production in the year 2021-22. I again wholeheartedly thank IPGA for this opportunity, and I will take any questions later on from the listeners. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Murthy, for a quite insightful of your presentation, which is not in the PowerPoint form, but very in a plain language. Now, one question I would like to put it here itself, that if you see that the production is going to be so high, does it mean that going forward, the dependence on imports from Myanmar would be much lower?
See, 2020-21, Myanmar support is a must for us because we are now running neck to neck in both consumption and demand. Consumption and supply.
I'm talking the next year, which you said you expect.
Next year, I presume I'm very, very optimistic about the next year, provided the rains should be normal. If the rains are not abnormal, there will be just no need for any imports of urad from Myanmar. I can guarantee this to you in this seminar.
You are giving shocks to the Myanmar producers, Mr. Murthy.
Oh, that is quite far away, Mr.
Murthy. I appreciate your patriotism feeling, you know.
Quite far away.
I know our personal discussion, which we had about 7 years back, when you said that India is going to be self-sufficient in future. And of course, they are on the way to it. But certainly, this is quite, I would say, eye-opening for everybody. Thank you so much.
You remember, I mentioned in the panel discussions that
we had discussed. In Delhi, we discussed, yeah.
This is much earlier. And it has turned out to be much earlier.
Okay. Achha, theek hai. Piyush Patel ji, aapka problem internet ka solve ho gaya. Can you please unmute yourself? Aap unmute kar dein.
Yeah.
Aur aapka introduction main de chuka tha, to apne, you can start with your presentation, please.